Hi everyone, I'm Francesco from Aiven. In today's video, we will check how you can read from an S3 bucket using ClickHouse and also how you can write to an S3 bucket from ClickHouse. So let's start. Okay, what we can see here is that I'm in Kaggle. There is a nice dataset called Tesla TSLH stock data, which contains all the latest data of the Tesla stocks. And what we will do is we will download it. You need to have a Kaggle account to download it. Once you download it, you can head to basically Amazon and S3, create an S3 bucket like I created. It's called My Aiven FT bucket. And I uploaded this Tesla raw data.csv that I found it in the zip file downloaded from Kaggle. I also included an empty Tesla clean data.csv that we will use later to write to S3 from ClickHouse. Together with the bucket, though, I also need to create a user. I called it my FT user bucket. And the my FT user bucket will have an associated policy that will contain, as we can see here, the ability to put and retrieve objects from the S3 bucket. And the S3 bucket is the My Aiven FT bucket that we saw before. So together with username, policy and bucket, the last bit is that in IAM, in the user that I just defined, I need to create an access key and an access token. This is what I will use from ClickHouse to basically access Amazon and then query S3. So let's now move to ClickHouse. You can run ClickHouse yourself, or like I did, I created a ClickHouse service in Aiven. It's easy to create. You just click on create service, select ClickHouse, select the cloud provider that you want, the service region that you want, the plan that can go from hobbies to business to premium, and then you give the service a name and you click on create service. I have one already there. If we check, it's called ClickHouse test. And if I click on it, I can retrieve the connection information. We are going to use the ClickHouse client on Docker in order to connect. So if we want to do that, we need to click on the ClickHouse native tab and check the details here, where we can find database, hostname, port, user, and password. Once we collect this information, we can navigate to our terminal and basically use the information to call the Docker run. And we are using the ClickHouse server, ClickHouse client image and passing the details of the username, the password, hostname, port. Don't worry, by the time that this video will be out, all these credentials will be gone, both in Aiven and in Amazon. So I'm connected to ClickHouse. The next step that I want to perform is to read the data from the S3 bucket. What I can do then is to use this SQL statement where I say it's with sample data as select star from the S3 bucket where I pass the S3 bucket URL together with the access key and the access token. Again, this will be expired by the time that you will see this video. And then I select all the columns that are coming from my CSV. So in just one step, I was able to read all the data from my S3 bucket. Okay, this was useful. What if I want to write to S3 now? Well, the pattern is almost the same. Instead of reading, I want to write. So what I can do is write a nice query that says that I want to insert into function S3 and the endpoint is, instead of the raw data, the clean data file. The key and secret is always the same. And then I'm retaking the data from the same S3 file. And at the end, I select the date open. So I select only two fields from my sample data. And I'm saying settings S3 truncate on insert equal to 1. What this will do is basically it will truncate the file Tesla clean data, and then repopulate with fresh data. So I can execute this insert now that will process, that will push the data to S3. And now if I query the data from the clean data file, I will see that I have my data there. So in the last few minutes, we saw how to basically query both as select, as an insert data in S3 from ClickHouse. This could be a powerful pattern, whether we want to store the data in a separate storage, which is not bundled with ClickHouse. By allowing us to select and to insert data to S3, we allow basically ClickHouse to be infinite with storage. We could separate hot data from cold data by keeping the hot data near where the ClickHouse engine is, and then pushing the cold data to S3 to store the cold data for a huge amount of time. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you do, click on subscribe on the Aiven YouTube channel, and I hope to see you soon. Bye from Francesco.